And welcome to another CRAS After Hours. Today, I have a very spooky technique called
Reverse Reverb.
So, the idea behind reverse reverb is that we want the reverb to be reverse of what it normally does. So, what does a reverb do? Well, when we have our initial sound, like a clap, then we have the reverberations of that sound hitting the walls in our adjacent spaces and actually eventually dying out in time as it loses power to continue traveling through the air. So that is our reverb time, our decay time, the RT60 time. So we have our initial hit, like the psh, and then we have the actual decay time as it decays out. So we have the psh, so psh, psh. There's our, yes, snare with my professional reverb tone there, indeed. So, I'm going to show us how we can actually have that reverb. So instead of having the tails becoming after the sound, the tails can be coming before the sound. So we'll actually have the reverb tails leading up to, and then our sound actually happen. So it kind of has this weird backwards kind of ghosting effect that I really like, and like I said, it's kind of spooky. So, what we need to start off with is some audio. So I recorded this little intro just for this particular event.
And now, how to do reverse reverb.
Yeah, so we're going to start with that. But like we said, we're going to be using reverb quite a bit here, so we're going to need to create some sort of reverb configuration. But we're also going to want to print the reverb, because that's going to be a key component into this as well. So let's create our new tracks. So Shift Command N, create new tracks. We're going to create a stereo aux input track. That's going to be our reverb unit, and then we're going to create a stereo audio track to actually print that too. So we have a stereo aux input track to actually put our reverb unit on, the stereo audio track to print that reverb too, so we can manipulate it later. Yes, indeed. So create those. Oh yeah. So now we need to go over, do a little bit of routing in our mix window. So first, we're going to create this reverb unit. So we're going to go up here, and this will work with any kind of processor too, so it doesn't just have to be reverb. Reverb is just one of the coolest ones, in my opinion, that you can use this with. So we have reverb, deverb. Like I said, anyone will work. We'll just use one of the stock verbs that comes with Pro Tools. So we got the deverb. And let's set up an interesting, very obvious kind of reverb tone. So we're going to go with church. Yes, let's go to church. And large church. I do enjoy large churches. Let's make it extra large, supersize. There we go, in the mid 30s, sounds good. Now we need to choose an input for this aux input track, because that is where we're going to be sending signal that we want to add reverb to. So we're going to choose internal routing within Pro Tools bus, and since we haven't used anything else, we're gonna go with bus 1 and 2. So bus 1 and 2 there. Now we're going to create a send and return configuration here with our reverb unit. So the next thing that we need to do is create our send to match with our return. So we got our bus 1 and 2 right there is our input. Then we need to send something to bus 1 and 2 as well right there. Cool. Now since we are going to a reverb unit, we don't need to set this to be pre-fader. But we do need to have some signal. So we're gonna go ahead and bring the signal up. If we hold option and click on the little fader, that'll bring it up to nominal level. Right up at 0 there, good time. So now we should be able to hear some sort of reverb happening.
And now, how to do reverse reverb.
Cool, so you can hear how long that actually takes to die out because we set a pretty high setting, 35 seconds really, for it to completely decay out. So that's going to be, of course, beyond our perception, but 35 seconds is how long it takes from the initial sound until it is no longer in existence, we'll say. So that is one thing to keep in mind for a little bit later. Now what we need to do is actually print this track. So we're going to need to do a little bit more routing to our audio track so we can actually keep it. So we're going to go ahead and use another unused bus, bus 3 and 4 in this case. And then we're going to go inline over here to bus 3 and 4 as well. So we're matching this up. So that way we actually have our original dry vocal, which is going on bus 1 and 2, hitting on our reverb there. So we have our big reverb settings that's going out on 3 and 4 to where we can print it on our audio track. Good times. So switch back over to our edit window and label this thusly. So verb. And then printed verb. All right, good times. So We have how to reverse, which is going to the verb track, which is going to be printed to the printed verb track. But like I said, this is a reverse reverb technique, so we need to do this in order to make it reverse correctly. Right. So now we're going to go to audio suite, other, reverse. So we're going to use it in the playlist, make sure that is on so that it actually shows up in our playlist here. But before we do that, speaking of playlists, let's use another playlist just in case anything funky happens. We always have a good playlist to go back to. So we have our dry, and then we can go ahead and create a duplicate playlist so it has the same stuff to work with, just in separate configurations. So in case we mess something up, we can always go back to it. So we're gonna go with reversed dry light on this one. And then we can actually render that. So now we have it reversed and we can listen to that too. Yes, sounds much like a demon incantation. So that's good stuff. But we can see that the playlist is important here because we go back to dry. There's our original signal in its original location. But we're going to use the reverse for right now. So now we have this going backwards. We're going to apply the reverb backwards as well. So it'll make sense in a second. But this is what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and record arm our printed verb track, which as we follow the signal flow once again, we have bus 1 and 2 going to our verb, getting printed out on 3 and 4 over here. So we're going to go ahead and record that. Good times. Okay, and I think it's beyond our perception at that point. So the main thing that we wanted to make sure of here is kind of jump the gun on this, but yeah, you want to make sure that actually you begin the recording before your first sound wave, and we cut that in just very closely. May have wanted to give myself a little bit more space, but oh well, it is what it is, and that's all that it is indeed. Hey, so we can take a listen to this again. If we listen to this, we'll hear a lot of verb on gibberish. Cool, but we're not done. We're almost done. What we need to do is reverse these both back so that way I'm talking forwards and kind of making sense, but then the reverse verb kind of matches up with my forward talking, not the reverse talking. So we're going to go and put our normal dry playlist back on there, and then we're going to need to reverse this one more time, render that. But now we can see that it's a little out of line. You're out of line. We're out of line. So we're going to take a look at this a little bit closer and match up the initial transients. It's kind of what we want to look for. So if we hit the grabber tool, drag this guy on over, and try to line this up. Now we are going to run out of space. Didn't leave myself enough space ahead of time, so I'm kind of going to cheat. But to match these up, we're going to move this way. Move this way a little bit longer. So we can see we have our major impact right there. We're kind of going to want to line those up close to each other. So we're going to ensmallen this track and embiggen this one and take a closer look. So we want to get pretty close here because, for example, if we're too far off, then it's not going to make sense.
And now.
So what we want to do is match those up a little bit more. So if we hit these initial transients pretty close, it should match.
And now.
So we can hear it's a little bit ahead of that.
And now, how to do reverse reverb.
And there you have it. So that's exactly how we wanted to have that lined up. So that way we have the entire lead up. And we'll go ahead and turn this volume up just a smidgen so we can hear it. But we'll hear the whole lead up, and then it'll still be speaking normally as I initially recorded it.
And now, how to do reverse reverb.
Indeed. And so that is how you do
reverse reverb.
Thank you very much. Think about any kind of other techniques that you could use this on. And get creative. You could even run multiple chains of this in series and get kind of all loco with it. Anyway, thanks for watching, have a good night, and we'll catch you later.